Hello and welcome to a new video about programming Arduinos. Up to now, our Arduino was not really useful. Yeah? We have programmed our first program. If we press a button, then an LED should be lit, and if we release the button, the LED should be turned off. Well, this would work very cheap or cheaper without controller, simply by using the button in the circuit of the LED. The Arduino doesn't make any sense. Therefore, we want to change our program, and we want to change it in a way that it does like this. Yeah? So if we press the button, it's lit. Okay. And if we release the button, it is still lit. So we can turn it on and it stays on. Okay. So the Arduino is now memorizing our button press. And if we press a second time and release, it shall be turned off. Yeah? So I can turn on and I can turn off the light. Yeah? Now the Arduino has something to do. Yeah? How to program this? Yeah? Well, you should try this. Yeah? You should really try this. I give you some hints. One thing you have to do for sure is to memorize something. Up to now, yeah, if you look, this is the program from last time. Yeah, this was this with the press the button and then lit, release the button, then off. Yeah. So, well, every time the loop is starting over, this button state will no longer know what it was before. Okay? If we want to memorize things longer than one loop, we have to define the variable somewhere else or somehow else. Yeah? You know, every time we are reaching this line, the variable is created, yeah? At a space in memory which is currently available. Yeah? This does not mean it's the same space as before, and this does not mean the content is the same. So every time loop is starting new, this button state will be created new. Yeah? So every time we see such line, the variable is created. This is why it does not know the variable what happened in last cycle. If we define something over here, and I call this now old button state. And I will, at the end, I will make a G for global. Then this variable, initialize this with zero. This variable is created at the beginning, so even before setup, at the beginning of the program. And if loop is starting new, we will not reach this line. So this will stay, this variable will stay. This will not be destroyed. Yeah? So at the end of the loop, button state is destroyed, but not old button state, because this is created outside as a so-called global variable. So this is why I use this G. Yeah? And if I want to remember what was the button state in the cycle before, I could write here at the end, old button state equals button state. Okay. This would work. And here at the beginning, I could ask if button state, yeah, is not like old button state. Then something has changed. Yeah? Then I either release the button or press the button the first time. Yeah? Because before it was not, it is a simply other state. So this means somewhere inside the cycle, somebody had pressed the button or released the button. Yeah? This would be one possibility to code this, yeah? To remember things over one cycle. Another possibility, you know, you could end up in a list of global variables there. If you want to group this somehow and make it there, make the definition there where you actually need it, you could also make it like this: old button state. I will also initialize this to zero. This would be the same like button state. Every time loop is starting new, old button state will also be created. And in the end, it will be destroyed. So, this is not working. However, I could use the keyword static. Static. Without Q. Static. Yeah. And now, with this keyword static, this will not be destroyed at the end of the loop. Yeah. This will stay. Because it's a static variable. It's defined a static variable. And if it stays, and we are getting back to this line, it will not be created new because the program remembers, hey, it's already there. So whatever is the content of this piece of memory where this is located, this will remain. Yeah? So I can now also use here old button state. Yeah? And use here also old button state. And this is working as well. So if you prefer to use global variables, or if you prefer to use static variables, I don't really care. Those things are equivalent. Yeah? I personally like these local static things, because then the definition of the variable is where it logically belongs, and this makes the codes, again, easier to maintain. Yeah? I think. If we would use this button state in another function as well, so if we would code here some other function, then there's no way around a global variable. Yeah? Or you hand it over to the function. This is also a tricky decision. How you prefer. I cannot give any good advice here, because sometimes it's better that way and sometimes it's more logical the other way around. Yeah, so I think with these memorizing to the next loop, you should be able to solve this issue. Yes? You should be able to make it like that I've just shown you. Press the button. Lit, release the button, lit, press the button off, release the button, stays off. Yeah? Memory. And if you're running into troubles and want to debug your code, in next video I show you somehow how you can make outputs to the screen of your computer from your Arduino. Serial monitor. Next time we're talking about serial monitor. For this time, thank you very much for listening, and goodbye.